Hi everyone, for today's lesson, we are going to learn about the Pythagorean theorem and how we can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve problems when we are given a right triangle. Our I can statement is I can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve problems. So notice that in my introduction, I have a right triangle, and we know it's a right triangle because it has that right angle symbol box inside of the triangle. And I have the letters A, B, and C because that is how we name a triangle. So let's go ahead and define what the Pythagorean theorem is. The Pythagorean theorem was developed by a man named Pythagoras, and he identified a special relationship that all right triangles shared. A theorem just simply means that it's a statement that has been supported as true repeatedly, and therefore it is accepted as true until it is not true. So this is our Pythagorean theorem. This is true for all right triangles, and it says if A and B are legs, which are the short sides of a right triangle, and C is the hypotenuse of a right triangle. Hypotenuse just means the longest side. Then the following has to be true. Then A squared plus B squared has to equal C squared. So what this is saying is that if you have A and B are legs, or the lengths of the short sides of a right triangle, and C is the hypotenuse of a right triangle, then A squared plus B squared has to equal C squared. So a right triangle simply means that it has a 90 degree angle symbol in it. So I'm going to draw a quick picture of a right triangle. A right triangle has a 90 degree angle symbol in it. One side, which is a shorter side, is called A. B is the other shorter side. And C is always across from the biggest angle. This is known as the hypotenuse, and we would say A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Now, triangles may be drawn differently, so I want you to be careful. The hypotenuse is always across from the right angle, where A and B will be in a different position. But regardless, what is true is that A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. So I'm just going to emphasize that in very large letters. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. This is something I need you to study and know. These are our sides, and they equal C squared, and C is always the hypotenuse, and the hypotenuse is always across from the right angle, so we call that opposite of the right angle. It is called the hypotenuse, which is the longest side. All right, cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem to help us to solve problems. So for this lesson, one of the things that I needed you to do is print out the Unit 1 Day 10 cutouts for the interactive notebook. I am using like a different colored paper, but what I want you to do is I want you to take what you cut out, and we are going to flip it upside down, and I would like you to please fold in all the way until it's like at the very edge of the hypotenuse, and I want you to fold all the way in so that's on the other side. So what we're going to do is we're going to create like a little pamphlet. And what we have here is, if the missing side is the hypotenuse, or if the missing side is a leg. Now remember, legs are the short side and hypotenuse is the long side. So for this lesson, if you have not already done so, you will need scissors and this cutout. You will want to have highlighters, because we always work with highlighters, and you will want to have a glue stick along with something to write with. You can also use scotch tape if you do not have glue at home. Okay, so let's go ahead and start talking about, let's say that the missing side is the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse means that the side that is missing is C, or the longest side. So what is missing is C, or the longest side. That's what we need to solve for. Let's go ahead and look at what those steps would be. So the first thing that we would want to do let me go ahead and zoom in so you can read what I'm about to write down. Alright, here are our steps. Step number one is to always label A, B, and C. Labeling is really helpful because it tells you what's going on in your problem. Step two, write the Pythagorean theorem. Step three, replace A and B in the equation. Obviously numbers that are part of your problem. So replace A and B in the equation. Step four is to simplify the exponents. Step five, add. Step six, square root both sides. Step seven, rewrite in simplified radical form if possible. So write the answer in simplified radical form, if possible. No decimals. No decimals are allowed unless it says so in the directions. So here are the steps. Let's go ahead and solve an example. Here we go. So what we have here is a triangle, and I'm going to draw a right triangle, and I'm going to show that this is my right angle. And I'm here to tell you that this side is 15, this side is 18, And I do not know what the other side is, so I'm going to call that C. So step number one is to label A, B, and C. So I'm going to label 15 with A and 18 with B. Step two, I'm going to write the Pythagorean theorem, just to remind myself that this is A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Then I'm going to replace A and B in the equation. So A is equal to 15, so that's going to be 15 squared, plus B is 18, so 18 squared equals C squared. Next, I'm going to simplify the exponents. So 15 squared is 225, 18 squared is 324, and this is equal to C squared. Step five is to add. This is where you might want to have a calculator. Any calculator will work, one on your computer, or you can also use a scientific calculator. This is a graphing calculator. So any calculator can do this work, and we end up with 549. All right, so now I end up with 549 is equal to C squared. Now, in order to get rid of the square, I need to square root both sides. So I'm going to take the square root of both sides, and what happens is that the square and the square root eliminate each other, leaving us with just the letter C on one side. When it comes to 549, we really want to like think about what numbers, what perfect square numbers can go into 549. So having a good calculator will help. So let's think about our list. We have 549. Let's see if it's divisible by 4. Nope, it ends up being a decimal, so 4 doesn't work. So let's try 549 divided by 9. There we go, 61. It works. So therefore, I'm going to rewrite this as 9 times 61. The square root of 9 is 3. 61 has no other perfect square factors. So 3 times the square root of 61 is equal to C, and this is my final answer. 3 times the square root of 61. All right, let's go ahead and look at, so I'm going to fold that in, and that is if the missing side is the hypotenuse. This is how you would solve it. Let's look at the other side. The other side is if the missing side is a leg. So let's go ahead and look at our steps for this. So the steps would be to number one, label A, B, and C. Step two, write the Pythagorean theorem. Step number three, replace A and C in the equation. Step four, simplify the exponents. Step five, subtract. What that means is you need to get B squared alone on one side. Step six, take the square root of both sides. Step seven, Write your answer. In simplified, radical form, if possible. Once again, no decimals are allowed. Decimals are only allowed if the directions say it's okay. Let's go ahead and look at this quick example, and I will go through the steps again. I'm going to go ahead and draw this right triangle. And in this right triangle, I have one side is equal to 6, and one side is equal to 10. So in this problem, I'm going to label 6 is A because it's considered a short side, and I'm going to label 10 as C because it's across from the right angle. I do not know what B is in this problem. So I'm going to start by writing the Pythagorean theorem of A squared plus B squared equals C squared, and I'm going to replace A and C in the equation. So this is going to be 6 squared plus B squared is equal to 10 squared. 6 squared, so simplifying the exponents, 6 squared is 36 plus b squared equals 100. Now I'm going to subtract 36 on both sides so that I can get b squared alone. 100 minus 36 is 64. Now I'm going to square root both sides. When I square root both sides, the square and the square root eliminate, leaving me with b equals the square root of 64 is 8. There is no radical left. B equals 8 is simply our answer. And that is all that we do for those problems. So go ahead and fold that in. And now we're going to paste this idea. Leave a little bit of space because there's one more thing I want to talk about, and that's going to be on the side, and that's a thing called a Pythagorean triple. So I'm going to fold this in, and I'm going to paste just the back. You can also use tape. I'm going to leave it on the side. What was really cool about this last example is that it turned out to be a really nice number. We didn't have to deal with radicals. We ended up with 8. How cool is that? So when this is actually called something special, 6, 8, 10. That is called a Pythagorean triple. And we're going to save this space for a thing called Pythagorean triples. Pythagorean triple. This is P-Y-T-H-A-G-O-R-E-A-N. Pythagorean triple. So what that means is that it's any time that there are three positive integers that satisfy, which satisfy means makes true, that satisfy the Pythagorean theorem. So some common Pythagorean triples that are common, and if you know them, you don't even have to show the Pythagorean theorem. So some that are common are 3, 4, and 5. Think about it. 3 squared plus 4 squared equals 5 squared. 9 plus 16 equals 25. It is a three whole numbers or integers that satisfy or works with the Pythagorean theorem. So 3, 4, 5 automatically works. Another one is 5, 12, and 13. 7, 24, 25. 8, 15, and 17. 9, 40, and 41. 11, 60, and 61. And 15, 112, and 113. These are some common Pythagorean triples where the Pythagorean theorem works every single time and you end up with no square roots. Now please also know that multiples of Pythagorean theorems or Pythagorean triples are also Pythagorean triples. So what I mean by that is 6, 8, and 10 also work because it comes from 3, 4, and 5. Think about it. 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8, 5 times 2 is 10. And that was our example. 6, this ended up being 8, and 10. This is a type of a 3, 4, 5 Pythagorean triple. Another one would be like 10, 24, and 26. That comes from the Pythagorean triple of 5, 12, and 13. Another one would be like 30, 40, and 50. That comes from 3, 4, 5. So any of the multiples means that it's multiplied by a number, are also Pythagorean triples. So just keep your eyes peeled for opportunities to save you time and where you don't have to really show much work. It's just always nice to know your Pythagorean triples. If you don't memorize them, that's okay. I just wanted you to have awareness of what a Pythagorean triple is. That is the end of today's lesson. If you have any questions over anything, please feel free to email me. Otherwise, I hope you have a wonderful day.